going, everyone? JD the Tank here, and welcome to episode 4 of Halo Tips. And before I get into today's episode, can you guess where I am? I like what map? Any ideas? You know, maybe Last Resort, maybe Valhalla. Where do you think I am? Look at and with this beautiful scenery behind me. Let's take a look, shall we? With the lovely trees and rocks to the right, or your right, I guess, my left, and then some more lovely trees and rocks to your left as well. And then another tower to your right, which you can't see because it's off camera. So, any idea, like, at all? Any clues? Nah, still nothing? Oh, guess I'm going to have to show you another clue then. So, I guess we'll get straight to it. Anyway, so, here's the second clue. Still any idea? No? I think I need to stop beating around the bush. It's pretty obvious. You've read the title. I'm on high ground. And in this episode, I'm going to show you how to get out of it, which is where the first clue was, actually. As you can see, I'm actually underneath a little cage thing, so, I guess I'll show you how to get in here, how I got in here. So this is actually underneath the stairs, in the little room between the tunnel and the bridge on high ground, the main gate bridge. And what you want to do is you want to have one person, you need two people to do this. You want one person in forge mode to, pick up a turret while someone's on it, and, yeah, and pretty much put them up against the stairs, how I've done there. And the other person, so this is from the other person's perspective now. The other person wants to, person on the turret, wants to look up as far as they can and then turn into monitor, which I do right there. And you're probably thinking to yourself, hold on a minute, where's his team colours? Like, is he using a mod or something? Well, there's actually a little bug, which I'm about to show you now. So as you see here, it's got the team right now, but if you go into like a free-for-all game type, such as Slayer, as I do right here, so I just accept it. As you see there, look, it actually changed. It went from being the team to the like just the regular nameplate. So let's not do the beeping sound because I got told off last time for doing that. So I will not do the beeping sound. Sorry for those that actually liked it. You load in like normal. As you see, there's no team. You'll be your Spartan color, whatever you chose. So mine's obviously the steel black color. Another thing you'll notice too is that usually see where it says where press up on the D-pad. Usually, I'm pretty sure it says Forge just on top of that, and it might say Forge on top where the scoreboard is too. And as you can also see, I'm not on a team or anything. I'm just like I'm a color and I'm meleeing. See, my armor's still the same. I go to kill myself here to show you. See, arm is all the same. Got the secondary and the primary all thing, and you can't go into settings either to change. Anyways, so have you ever wanted to go to the beach one day, but then for some reason there was just a massive invisible wall blocking you from going? You know, it sucked, didn't it? You know, and you'd be like, oh well, what's the point? I can't get in. So you'd have to go home all depressed and sad and walk away very slowly, which I'm about to do right now. Man, I just wanted to go for a swim today. Why couldn't I go for a swim? Stupid invisible walls. But wait, I'm telling you now, there is something you can do. There is hope. Trust me, you can come back. Come back, JD! Anyways, what you want to do is, you want to grab a teleporter, preferably a receiver node, obviously here, and don't, so if you try and put it like that, see, it just bounces right off. So what you want to do is, you want to kind of go more to the left, so I kind of start off not doing it. But then, so you kind of go more towards those rocks, and you just drop it, and it'll work. And then you want to place a sender node or two-way or whatever receiver will connect. I'm pretty sure sender's the primary thing. And you'll be outside. There you go. Now you can finally go for that swim that you really wanted to. Like, how about that? Hallelujah. So I'm just, you know, having a good time, jumping around, you know, finally getting that swim that I wanted. For all these years, I always wanted to swim in this particular lake. And as you look at over here, look at the beautiful trees I mentioned earlier. Look at them. When you're underwater, they turn like a purpley color. That is so cool, isn't it? I think that's kind of cool. So, you have to be very careful, though, because there are a lot of death barriers out here. Like, lots and lots and lots of death barriers. So, I'm telling you now, like, the amount I died, like, 40-plus times trying to make this, this video, man. Like, it was ridiculous trying to get this stuff set up. And there's a little area here. This is actually roughly where I was standing for the first clue. So there you go. Everything's been revealed now. And I don't know if you saw just before, you're actually under the water. Even there, it's just you don't really see it. So I think I'm yeah, I just hit a death barrier. So these death barriers, they're very, very finicky. Like you'll randomly just die like at random points. Like you'll never be consistent. So you'll die in one spot and then maybe you won't die in that spot then, but then like a second later you might die in that. It's just it's weird. It's but yeah, right here I'm showing off just the mountain range, just out all the out of the map stuff you can see. And then here's another one. See, I'm walking around for a bit and then I just randomly die. Like that makes no sense. And the time's always different. Yeah, like I said, there's like a 40 amount of, I died at least 40 different times while recording for this video, not including these. These are just some couple spare times I died. Anyway, so you probably wonder what else can you do back here other than go for a nice swim? Well, you can actually spawn pretty much anything you want out here, just not too far though, because obviously the death barriers will just delete the items. But I just see I just spawned a ghost. Now spawning a mongoose, so I'm like kind of driving a mongoose underwater, which doesn't really make any sense because you're pretty sure the engine would flood. But yeah, then I spawn a warthog. This is kind of cool what I do here. So I kind of jump in it and I'm shooting it. Look at like it's like a weird, cool like yellow effect in the water. And no, not wee. It's a good kind of yellow, not a bad kind of yellow. And I try to get in the wraith here, but I accidentally got in the turret instead. This is kind of cool. It's kind of like mortars coming from the beach. I guess that's going to trigger someone. I don't know. Anyways, yeah, I'm just shooting the wraith stuff. And then one last vehicle I decided to spawn in is the tank. Now, I think this is terrifying, horrifying, or terrifying, or terrifyingly horrifying. I don't know. But imagine just seeing this random tank cannon just shooting out of the water. Just all, like it's kind of like seeing that shark fin, you know? It's just all you see is that, and it's like, oh no, I'm done. But that's pretty much everything. You can spawn practically anything. I don't bother spawning anything else. I just spawned a bunch of vehicles because that's all I really did at the time. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed today's episode of How to Get Out of High Ground. And for those of you wondering, from the last episode, the lasers, the sandbox lasers, they did quite the number on my armor, but I think I'm okay. I did get told though not to go into any kind of deep water. I'm kind of violating the issue, but. Anyways, this video has taken so long to upload. Hold on a minute. Why am I getting a warning in my suit? Oh no. Wait. There's a breach? There's a breach in my suit? Oh, no. No. Oh, God. No. What am I gonna. I can't move. My arm is locking up. No. 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 Oh, no. Oh, water's slowly coming into my helmet. Okay, I think I can't move. What am I gonna do? Oh no. Help me. Help me, everyone. So this video took 2 weeks to upload. I'm sorry I took so long. Hopefully the next one won't take as long. I'm okay. Okay. Oh no. I'm being pushed back now. Oh no. No. You're still here. It's over. Go home. Like, really, the show's over. Go home, what are you doing here still? Well, actually, there is one more thing I'd want to show you guys. Before I get to that though, I just want to say a couple. I want to mention a couple of things that I forgot to mention during the main part of the video. So the first thing was. The team like no colors, no teams in Forge, pretty much. That only seems to work on Halo 3. I tried it on the other games, and it doesn't seem to work. And the other thing was the reason this video took so long to make is because I got very experimental with it, thought of all these different ideas to bring in. So that's why. Anyways, hope you enjoy. This thing coming up is called a Death Tage. Hope you enjoy, and until next time. Chica.
We'll be right back.